This is Percy, the skipper of the... What's this boat called?
Matthew Flinders. Right.
Matthew Flinders, yeah.
So when we get to what we call Long Island, just here, we turn, we come up into Franklin Sound, follow along here, up past the islands, through the sand. Between the dogs, we call this. It's pretty narrow. And then we get up into Lady Barron, which is just there, which is the dogs. Come through the narrow bit, down through here, Green Island, and then over to Lady Barron, which is we birth here. Thank you.
every human being, they must have a dream, you know.
Still quite far, I think. Six sets of birds can be done.
That was cool, wasn't it?
Yeah, I'm going to catch some more water and give it to the other plants.
Okay. How long have you lived here for?
I've been here about 22 years now.
Okay.
Yeah. It was my savior. When I signed off the ship, I was a wreck. And it was my savior.
And so you were, now tell us about your background on the sea. You grew up in Sweden, right?
I started as a 16-year-old one. I ran away from school. And then I started off in the engine room for 4 years.
Was this with the Swedish Navy?
Swedish Merchant Navy, yeah.
Okay.
But then the engines wasn't my cup of tea, really. So I went to maritime school and got a wireless operator ticket. And that was a bloody good job.
So you used lots of Morse code?
Oh, all the time, yeah. It was the best job I ever had.
And that you traveled all around the world doing that?
Yeah. Oh, it's just great. Great friendships. Jeff and Lisbeth, welcome to Flinders Island.
Okay.
Oh, my lieutenant.
Hello,
making all the roots loose for all the weeds with the fork.
Good thing with working at sea was that you worked for 12 months, saved all your money, and then you could have bloody 1 year holiday.
And what
was plenty of work. You just lifted a telephone and you had a job.
So, give me an example of one of your favorite years off between sailing that you went. What did you do during that year?
Oh, the years I spent here in Australia.
Okay.
Absolutely.
And so, didn't you say that at one point you were living back in Sweden, and then a bunch of yellow snow fell?
Yeah, I had a big farmhouse in Sweden, and I renovated it over a 10-year period. And one day in the winter, I hated the winter; they were bloody dark and miserable. And one winter, the snow was yellow, greyish, and it was hard on the ground. And I said, and the elm trees were dying. And I said, this is it, no more.
And that's when you left Sweden and came back here for good?
That's when I left Sweden and for good, yeah.
I started with my rainbow fur. But I need some red.
This is the refrigerator.
I didn't know that, you know. It's... I save some vegetables for tomorrow. Very few zucchini. Does that have to go in there?
The jelly should, yeah.
Yeast and butter. And we also have bread. Should we put that in there?
Oh, maybe the new loaf. And it closes back. There's the little latch there.
This is Arnie's shower. There's the kitchen right there. Here's the cherry tomatoes growing. Yeah, you can look out and see the ocean.
They wanted wireless operators in the Antarctica.
Okay.
But on the way, I came here and I read about Flinders Island on the plane, and I thought, oh, I better have a look and look at Flinders before I go to the Hobart.
So what did they say on the plane?
It was just a brochure I read.
Did it show some photos?
So I came here for a week and I stayed at Killiecrankie. And I said, this is it. And then I was going to Hobart and joined the bloody Antarctic Division.
Did you?
Oh, I felt miserable. So after, there was 1 month left and we were going to sail for Antarctica and I broke the contract.
Uh-oh.
I said, no, I'm not going. So I went back to sea, got the money and bought the land.
Really? And what year was that?
I bought the land 85.
That's some good shit.
Do they bite the grasshoppers, do they?
I don't think so. They might want to lay eggs in you, though. Isn't that the horde of locusts from the Book of Revelation?
Well, you know, they just need a day and everything is gone.
Yeah.
That's what's going to happen with humanity, you know.
They're going to eat us?
You have to start to eat a grasshopper.
Supposedly they're actually quite nutritious.
After they fed on the vegetables.
Yeah. Thank you.